Awesome. Awesome. You know, when God gets a hold of your heart, when you're touched by his presence and his love, you can't help but want to sing joyful songs like that and sing of his faithfulness. So we're going to just continue that. Is that all right? guys go ahead and please take your seats? Is that right? That was a fun moment. You know, in the Gospel of John and the letters of John in the New Testament, he boils things down in its simplest form, because he's an older man. He's trying to give a message to what really matters to the next generations. And it's about loving God, being fully convinced that God loves you. Fully convinced. And when that happens, you have hope. You have confidence. You have joy in the middle of sorrow. This song is called My Hope. This is the moment where we want to quiet our hearts and listen very carefully to the Word of God and the message. Would you please welcome Reverend Franklin Graham?
Good evening.
God kveld.
It is Been a wonderful weekend here in Oslo.
Det har vært en vidunderlig helg her I Oslo.
And we're so thankful for the invitation from the committee.
Vi så takknemlige for invitasjonen som vi har fått ifra komiteen.
From the churches.
Ifra menighetene.
That extended the invitation for us to come.
Og de som har gitt oss denne, alle de som har vært med å gi oss denne invitasjonen til å komme.
Now we have enjoyed every moment.
Og vi har gledet oss hele tiden.
We have had an opportunity to eat some of your food.
Vi har hatt anledning til å spise noe av maten som dere spiser her.
I went to one of your famous restaurants last night after the meeting.
Jeg har vært til en av deres kanskje mest berømte restauranter etter møtet I går.
McDonald's. And I had a quarter pounder with cheese.
Der hadde jeg en quarter pounder med ost.
But we have made many friends here.
Men vi har fått mange gode venner her.
And we've had many memories.
Og har med oss mange gode minner.
And we hope that the Lord will allow us to return someday.
Og vi håper også at Herren tillater oss å komme tilbake en dag.
I want to thank the executive committee and especially our chairman for all of their hard work.
Jag måste tacka den utövande kommittén som vi har och speciellt formann och allt det harda arbetet som det här har utfört.
I want to thank all of the volunteers.
Och jag måste tacka alla frivilliga.
The ushers.
De som har varit medhjälpare här sån.
The counselors.
Alla som har varit rådgivare.
All those that have been working behind the scenes.
Alla de som har arbetat liksom bak scen och runt omkring.
These type of things just don't happen.
Du vet att det slike ting som detta sker inte av sig själv.
It takes prayer.
Det krävs massa bön.
It takes prayer.
Det krävs bön.
It takes prayer.
Och det krävs bön.
It takes hard work.
Och det krävs hårt arbete.
And it takes a lot of skill for something like this to take place.
Och det krävs massa egenskaper och evner för att få till något som detta.
So we thank God and we give him the glory tonight.
Så vi tackar Gud och ger äran till han ikväll.
I want to take just a moment and speak to you tonight.
Jag önskar att bruka lite tid och så tala till dig ikväll.
You have a soul.
Du har en själ.
You see, when God made us and created us,
när Gud skapade oss och format oss,
He gave us a DNA.
Då gav han dig ett DNA.
No one else has your DNA.
Det ingen andra som har det DNA som du har.
Out of the billions of people on the earth today, no one has your genetic code.
Ut av de miljarderna av människor på kloden idag så är det ingen som har makan till din kod.
You're unique.
Du är unik.
No one in history before you had your DNA.
Och det ingen I historien för dig som har haft ditt DNA.
You have a thumbprint or fingerprints.
Du har ett fingeravtryck
that are uniquely to you.
Som också är helt unikt för dig.
No one has your fingerprint.
Det är ingen andra som har det fingeravtrycket.
No one in all of history has had your fingerprint.
Ingen I historien har haft ditt fingeravtryck.
You are a unique individual that God made and created and gave you a soul.
Så du är en unik individ med en unik själ skapt I dig.
And your soul never dies.
Och din själ, den dör aldrig.
Your soul will live as long as God lives.
Din själ kommer att leva lika länge som Gud lever.
And your soul is going to reside one day either in heaven or hell.
Och din själ vill en dag enten vara I himlen eller I helvete.
One day they're going to bury you in the ground.
En dag så kommer du till att begravas I jorden.
Oh, you may not want to think about that.
Möjligt du inte trivs med tanken om det.
But these bodies of ours are going to die.
Men denna kroppen vår den kommer till att dö.
And then we stand before God in judgment.
Och därefter ska vi stå framför Gud I domen.
That's right, you have a soul.
Det är riktigt. Du har en själ.
And when you take your last breath on this earth,
lik att när du tar din sista pust på denna jorden,
you are transported into eternity.
Så överförs du till evigheten.
And it's either heaven or hell.
Och det är enten himmel eller helvete.
And there are many of you here tonight, you're close to losing your soul.
Många av er som är här ikväll är I färd med att mista själen deras.
And I want you to listen tonight.
Och jag vill att du ska höra gott efter ikväll.
Because there's a man in the Bible that I want to read about.
Det är en person I Bibeln som vi ska läsa om.
who was close to losing his soul.
Han var så tätt på att miste sin själ.
And he met Jesus Christ.
Och så mötte han Jesus Kristus.
And tonight you can meet that same Jesus Christ here tonight at the Spectrum.
Och ikväll kan du möta den samma Jesus Kristus här I Spectrum.
God loves you.
Fordi Gud elsker dig.
You have a uniqueness.
Du har en unik egenskap för dig själv.
A DNA.
Du har ett DNA.
A fingerprint.
Du har ett fingeravtryck.
A soul that is unique to you.
Du har en själ som är unik för dig.
God loves you.
Gud älskar dig.
But you're in danger of losing your soul.
Men du är I fara för att mista din själ.
So we're going to look at a passage of scripture.
Så vi ska se på ett skriftavsnitt.
In Luke chapter 19.
Vi ska se på Lukas kapitel 19. Jesus kom in I Jeriko och gick genom byn. Och se, det var en man som hette Zacchaeus som var övertoller och han var rik. Han ville gärna se vem Jesus var, men han kom inte till på grund av folkmängden sedan han var liten av växt. Så sprang han I förvägen och klättrade upp I ett morbärträ för att se han, sedan han måste gå förbi den vägen. Da Jesus kom till stedet så han upp, fästet blicket på ham och sa: "Zacchaeus, skynd dig och kom ner, för idag må jag vara I ditt hus." Så skyndte han sig och kom ner och han tog emot Jesus med glädje. Men da de så det, klaget alla och sa: "Han har tagit in som gäst hos en syndig man." Da stod Zacchaeus fram och sa till Herren: "Se Herre, jag ger halvparten av allt jag äger till de fattige. Hvis jeg har tatt noe fra noen ved falske anklager, så gir jeg det tilbake fire ganger så mye." Jesus sa til ham: "I dag frelse kommet til dette hus, for også han en Abrahams sønn, for menneskesønnen kommet for å søke og frelse det som var fortapt."
The occasion Jesus was passing through Jericho.
Anledningen at Jesus på vei gjennom til Jericho.
He was now on his way to Jerusalem.
Han var altså på vei til Jerusalem.
To the cross where he would die for our sins.
Han på vei til det korset der Jesus en gang skal da dø for våre synder. Jesus skulle dø for våre synder.
But he's on his way through Jericho, the small town.
Her kommer han på vei gjennom Jericho, som bare en bitteliten by.
Jericho is still there today.
Jericho jo der den dag I dag.
Very small, dirty little town.
Fortsatt en liten by, en skitten liten by.
But in Jesus' time, it was an important city.
På Jesus sin tid så var det en viktig by.
Caravan routes came through there.
Där var det karavaner som kom igenom.
About 17 miles from Jerusalem.
Det låg omtrent 27 kilometer från Jerusalem.
And so the Romans put a tax collecting office there.
Så de romarna, de placerade ett skattekontor, ett skatteinkrävningstollkontor där.
And Zacchaeus was the head of the office.
Där var Zacchaeus ledare för detta kontoret.
Now he was a Jew.
Han var ju jude.
And he worked for the Romans.
Och så jobbar han.
He was a collaborator.
Alltså en som var blandat in och som de inte likte, en sviker.
He was hated and despised by his fellow countrymen.
Så han var hatad och föraktad av alla sina medborgare.
Maybe like when the Nazis came during the Second World War.
Möjligt var slikt när nazisterna kom här under den andra världskriget.
Maybe there were a few people that collaborated with the Nazis.
Och då hade du människor som samarbetat med nazisterna.
And they would have been hated and despised by their fellow countrymen.
Och det att de blev både hatet och föraktet av de andra norrmännen här.
This is the case with Zacchaeus.
Det situationen med Zacchaeus.
He was hated.
Han blev hatet.
He lied.
Han löj.
He cheated people.
Han bedrog människor.
He overtaxed them.
Han gav dem för hög skatt.
And he put that extra money in his pocket.
Och de extra pengarna putt han I lomma.
And so he had become quite wealthy.
Så han hade blivit ganska förmögen.
And he was hated. Now Jesus was passing by.
Så kommer Jesus och passerar.
And Zacchaeus wanted to come to Jesus.
Och Zacchaeus önskade att komma till Jesus.
And maybe you have come tonight.
Kanske du har kommit här ikväll.
And you thought to yourself, I would like to be able to come to Jesus.
Kanske du hade tänkt med dig själv också. Jag skulle gärna komma till Jesus.
I would like to tell him about my problems.
Jag skulle gärna snacka med han om mina problem.
I would like to get his advice.
Jag skulle gärna fått hans råd.
I'd like to get his help to change my life.
Fått hans hjälp att förändra mitt liv.
You can have that tonight.
Det kan du göra ikväll.
And I'm going to give you an opportunity tonight.
Och jag kommer att ge dig anledning till det här ikväll.
And if you're here tonight and you've never trusted Jesus Christ.
Om du är här ikväll och du aldrig har satt din lit till Jesus Kristus.
I'm going to give you that chance tonight.
Så vill du få den möjligheten ikväll.
To meet Jesus Christ here.
Där du kan möta Jesus Kristus här.
To put your faith and trust in him.
Att du kan sätta din tro och din tillit till ham.
Tonight your life can be changed.
Ikväll kan ditt liv bli förändrat.
You can have that assurance that your soul is secure in the hands of Almighty God.
Du kan få denne forsikringen om at din sjel trygg I Guds hender.
And I'm going to invite you in a few moments.
Og jeg kommer til å invitere deg om litt grann her.
To get up out of your seat.
Der du kan komme opp av plassen din.
And make your way and stand in front of this podium.
Og der du vil komme fram her og stå foran her podiet.
And when we've all come.
Og når vi alle samlet der.
We'll have a word of prayer together.
Så skal vi be sammen.
So you come tonight.
Så du kan komme I kveld.
I'll call you in just a few minutes.
Jeg skal kalle på deg om bare et lite grann.
Jesus was passing by.
Jesus var på vei igjennom.
Zacchaeus wanted to come to Jesus.
Og Zacchaeus ville gjerne komme til Jesus.
But there were obstacles.
Men det var en del hindringer I veien.
There was this large crowd.
Det var en stor menneskemengde der.
You see, wherever Jesus went, there was always this crowd.
Overalt hvor Jesus beveget seg, så var en stor menneskemengde.
Hundreds.
Hundrevis.
Thousands.
Tusenvis.
And there were people yelling, Jesus.
Og mennesker ropte, Jesus.
Over here, Jesus.
Her borte, Jesus.
I want you to come see my son.
Kom og besøk min sønn.
I want you to see my mother.
Besøk min mor.
Calling, always calling his name.
De ropte, ropte alltid på hans navn.
And Zacchaeus is a small guy.
Zacchaeus, han var jo kort av vekst.
And this crowd is now an obstacle.
Slik at denne store folkemengden var et problem for ham.
What's your obstacle tonight?
Hvilke hindringer står du overfor I kveld?
Preventing you from coming to Christ.
Hva som hindrer deg fra å komme til Kristus?
You see, God loves you.
Du skjønner, Gud elsker deg.
Zacchaeus was a little guy. He was short.
Zacchaeus var jo kortvokst, en liten fyr.
Yeah, I'm sure he stood up on his tiptoes.
Jeg sikker på han prøvde å stå på tærne først.
Still couldn't see over the crowd.
Kunne fortsatt ikke se over menneskemengden.
And maybe you feel that you're little in the eyes of God.
Og det mulig du der at du føler at du så liten og ubetydelig I Guds øyne.
You would say, Franklin, God wouldn't notice my life.
Så kan du si, ja, men Franklin, Gud vil ikke legge merke til meg engang.
Why wouldn't he?
Hvorfor skulle han ikke det?
He made you.
Han har jo skapt deg.
He created you.
Han har formet deg.
He gave you a special genetic code.
Han har gitt deg en spesial genetisk kode.
He gave you a fingerprint that nobody else has.
Han har gitt deg et eget fingeravtrykk som ingen andre har.
He gave you a soul.
Han har gitt deg en sjel.
Of course you're important to God.
Selvfølgelig du viktig for Gud.
He loves you.
Han elsker deg jo.
Will you come to him tonight?
Vil du komme til ham I kveld?
You say, but Franklin, how do you know that God loves me?
Men så sier du, Franklin, hvordan vet du at Gud elsker meg da?
The Bible.
Du skjønner Bibelen.
God's word.
Guds eget ord.
Says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but should have everlasting life.
Gud, så har Gud elsket verden, at han ga sin eneste sønn, for at hver den som tror på han, ikke skal gå fortapt, men ha evig liv.
What's the obstacles? Preventing you from coming to Christ tonight.
Så vilken hindring det du ser för dig som hindrar dig från att komma till Kristus ikväll?
Sin is an obstacle.
Synd en av dessa hindringar kanske.
Sin is disobedience to God's laws and his standards.
Synd olydighet mot Guds lov och hans standard.
You say for Franklin the world is a big place and we have different cultures.
Ja, säger du Franklin, världen är ett stort ställe och det är många olika kulturer om detta.
There's different standards.
Man har olika standarder.
And things are accepted today that maybe weren't accepted even 50 years ago.
Well, there are things som accepteres idag som ikke ble akseptert for 50 år siden.
God's standards are the same yesterday, today, and tomorrow.
Guds standard, den den samme I går og I dag og I morgen.
They're going to be the same a million years from now.
Og de kommer til å være akkurat den samme om en million år.
God does not change his standards.
Gud forandrer ikke på sin standard.
As culture changes, God doesn't change.
Selv om kulturen endres, så endres ikke Gud.
He's the same.
Han den samme.
Telling a lie is a sin.
Så å lyve en synd.
Have you ever lied?
Har du noen gang løyet?
You say, well, no, you're a liar.
Og så sier du, nei, du allerede en løgner.
We've all lied.
Vi alle løyet.
We're all guilty. Franklin Graham is guilty.
Vi alle skyldige. Franklin Graham skyldig.
Stealing is a sin.
Det å stjele en synd.
Adultery.
Odrivi hor en synd.
Any type of sexual relationship outside of a marriage relationship is a sin against God.
Alle seksuelle relasjoner utenom ekteskap en synd mot Gud.
Now, when I say a marriage relationship, I'm talking about a marriage relationship between a man and a woman.
Og når jeg sier ekteskap, så mener jeg et ekteskap mellom mann og kvinne.
Not two women,
ikke to kvinner.
Not two men,
ikke to menn.
God's standards is marriage is a man and a woman.
Fordi at Guds standard ekteskapet mellom mann og kvinne.
And there are many of you here tonight you're guilty of sexual sins.
Og mange som her I kveld skyldig I seksuelle synder.
You have felt dirty, you have felt guilty about it.
Og så har du følt deg både skitten og ansvarlig I forhold til det.
But I'm here tonight to tell you that God will forgive you.
Men jeg her for å si at Gud vil tilgi deg.
But you have to come to God His way.
Og at du må komme til Gud på den måten som han har gitt oss.
And that's through Jesus.
Og den veien han har tilveiebrakt gjennom Jesus Kristus.
Murder is a sin.
Mord en synd.
You say, well, Franklin, of course it is. We understand that one.
Selvfølgelig, det skjønner vi da, det forstår vi.
Abortion.
Abort.
That's right.
Ja.
In God's eyes, it is considered murder in His eyes.
I Guds øyne så det ansett som en synd.
And there, some of you here tonight, you may be guilty of having an abortion.
Og noen av dere her I kveld skyldige I det å ha hatt en abort.
And you felt guilty.
Og du kjent på skyldfølelsen.
But tonight, God will forgive you.
I kveld så vil Gud tilgi deg.
A number of years ago, I was being interviewed by a lady from New York.
For mange år siden så var jeg et interview med en kvinne fra New York.
The interview went for a couple of hours.
Vi holdt på noen timer.
So after a couple of hours, I said, "Can I ask you some questions?"
Så etter noen timer så sa jeg, "Nå kan jeg kanskje få lov til å stille deg noen spørsmål."
She took her pen and paper and laid them down on the table.
Så hun la ned pen og papir og la det på bordet.
She said, "Go ahead."
Vær så god, sa hun.
I said, "Are your sins forgiven?"
Da sa jeg, dine synder tilgitt?
And tears filled up in her eyes.
Med en gang så kom tårene I øynene hennes.
She said, "I don't think so."
Så sa hun, nei, det tror jeg ikke.
I said, "Would you like to know?"
Vil du gjerne vite da?
"Would you like to be forgiven?"
Vil du gjerne bli tilgitt?
She said, "Yes, I would."
Så sa hun, ja, det vil jeg gjerne.
And tears were coming down her cheeks.
Og tårene begynte å renne.
I said, "Did you know that God loves you?"
Jeg sa, visste du at Gud elsker deg?
He sent his son Jesus Christ from heaven to this earth for you.
Och han sände sin son från himlen och hit till för dig, för din skull.
When Jesus died on the cross.
När Jesus döde på korset.
He took your sins.
Så tog han dina synder.
He died in your place.
Han döde på ditt ställe.
And if you're willing to believe on him.
Och hvis du vill tro på ham.
God will forgive you tonight.
Så ska Gud tillgi dig ikväll.
I asked her, I said, "Would you like to invite Christ to come into your life?"
Så spurte henne, vill du invitera Kristus att komma in I ditt liv?
"Would you like to trust him as your savior?"
Och ha tillit till han som din frälser?
"Are you willing to turn from your sins?"
Är du villig till att snu dig bort ifrån din synd?
"And believe in faith on his name?"
Och ha tro på hans namn?
She said yes.
Så sa hon ja.
So I had a prayer with her.
Så jag bad för henne.
Just like I'm going to have with many of you in a few minutes.
Akkurat slik som jag ska be med många av er nu om någon få minuter.
And after I prayed with her.
Och efter vi hade bett samman.
She confessed her sins to God.
Så bekände hon sina synder till Gud.
Asked for his forgiveness.
Hun bad om hans tillgivelse.
And said to God, "I believe that Jesus is your son."
Och han sa, Gud, jag tror att Jesus din son.
And I want to trust him.
Och jag vill ha tillit till honom.
As my savior.
Jag vill stole på han som min frälsare.
And follow him as my lord.
Och jag vill följa han som min herre.
After she prayed this prayer.
Efter hon hade bett den bön.
She looked at me, she got very intent.
Så såg hon på mig, hon var väldigt intens och bestämd.
She said, "I have to confess something."
Hon sa, jag må få lov att bekänna någonting, sa hon.
Said, "You don't have to confess anything to me. God has just heard your prayer. He's forgiven you."
Så sa du tänker inte bekänna något som helst för mig. Gud har hört din bön. Han har tillgett dig.
She said, "No, I have to say this."
Nej, jag måste si följande, sa hon.
She said, "20 years ago I had an abortion."
För 20 år sedan så hade jag en abort.
"Will God forgive me for what I did?"
Kan Gud tillge mig för det jag gjorde?
I said, "He just did."
Jag sa, han har akkurat gjort det.
"You're forgiven."
Du är tillgett.
And she said, "For 20 years it has haunted me."
Hun sa, I 20 år så har dette etterjaget meg og plaget meg.
She said, "There wasn't a day that went by that I didn't think about that child."
Det ikke en dag som har gått uten at jeg har tenkt på dette barnet.
"What that child would have been like."
Hva dette barnet ville ha vært, hvordan det ville ha vært.
She said, "The guilt and the shame has haunted me all of my life."
Og min skyld og min skam har etterjaget meg hele mitt liv.
"Will God forgive me?"
Kan Gud tilgi meg?
"He just did. He's forgiven you."
Han har akkurat gjort det, sa jeg. Han har tilgitt deg.
And she took her face and put him in her hands and she just wept.
Og så tok hun hendene og ansiktet I hendene og hun bare gråt.
For the first time in 20 years she was set free.
For første gang på 20 år så hun satt fri.
You see, God wants to forgive sin.
Du skjønner, Gud vil tilgi synd.
If you had kept all of God's laws except one.
Om du hadde alle Guds lover unntagen én.
You're guilty.
Så du da også skyldig.
The Bible says that we have all sinned and come short of God's glory.
For Bibelen sier at vi har alle syndet og vi fattes Guds ære.
That the wages of sin is death.
Og at syndens lønn døden.
You see, there is a death sentence over the human race.
Så det er en dødsdom over hele menneskeheten.
But God so loved you.
Men Gud elsket deg så.
That he sent his son from heaven to this earth.
At han sendte sin sønn fra himmelen til denne jorda.
To take our sins.
For å ta våre synder.
He became a sacrifice to God for our sins.
Han ble et offer til Gud for våre synder.
He died in our place.
Han døde I vårt sted.
And we can be set free.
Og vi kan bli satt fri.
If you're willing to put your faith in Christ.
Om du villig til å sette din tro til Kristus.
No person in history has taken your sins.
Det ingen person I historien som har tatt din synd.
Buddha didn't take your sins.
Buddha har ikke tatt noen av dine synder.
Shiva didn't take your sins.
Shiva har ikke tatt noen av dine synder.
Muhammed didn't take your sins.
Muhammed har ikke tatt noen av dine synder.
Only one, and that's Jesus Christ, the Son of God.
Det bare en som har gjort det. Jesus Kristus, Guds sønn.
The Bible says if we claim to be without sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us.
Bibeln säger att om vi säger om oss själva att vi inte har synd så har vi bedratt oss själva och sanningen är inte I oss.
How about you?
Hur är det då med dig?
Are your sins forgiven?
Är dina synder tillgitt?
Are you sure?
Är du helt säker?
You see, Zacchaeus wanted to come to Jesus.
Du ser, Zacchaeus önskade gärna att komma till Jesus.
He wanted to see Jesus for himself.
Han önskade själv att möta Jesus och se Jesus för egna ögon.
Tonight, do you want to come to Jesus?
I kväll önskar du att komma till Jesus.
You see, the Bible says the blood of Jesus cleanses us from all sin.
Bibeln säger att Jesu blod renser oss från all vår synd.
The Bible tells us through faith we have peace with God.
Bibeln säger att vi tro så har vi fred med Gud.
Jesus was passing by.
Jesus var på genomreise.
There's a big crowd. Zacchaeus couldn't see over him.
Men den stora gruppen människor Zacchaeus kunde inte se över dem.
Now he was a pretty smart guy.
Men han var en smart fyr.
He ran ahead.
Han löp I förväg.
He saw where Jesus was going.
Han skönte var Jesus skulle gå.
And he climbs up into a sycamore fig tree.
Och så klättrar han upp I ett morbärträ.
And so he's just sitting up there watching the whole thing.
Och där sitter han och kan se allt som sker.
And then here comes Jesus.
Och så kommer Jesus gående.
Large crowd.
Stor folkemängd.
Many people are calling his name.
Många människor som ropar på hans namn.
Sure, there was a lot of commotion.
Massa uppstyr och bevegelse.
But Jesus looked up and saw Zacchaeus.
Men Jesus såg upp och såg Zacchaeus.
Called him by name.
Kallade han vid namn.
And you see, Jesus knows your name.
Du ser, Jesus känner ditt namn.
Jesus saw him.
Jesus såg ham.
He sees you here tonight.
Han ser dig ikväll.
And Jesus stopped.
Och Jesus stansat upp.
Remember, he was on the way to Jerusalem.
Husk, han var på väg till Jerusalem.
He was on the way to the cross.
Han var på väg till korset.
And Jesus saw Zacchaeus.
Och så ser Jesus Zacchaeus.
He stops.
Han stansar upp.
And he called him by his name.
Och kallar han vid hans namn.
Is he calling you tonight?
Kallar han på dig ikväll?
Has there been a little voice in your heart saying, "I need to do this tonight"?
Har du hört en liten stämma I ditt hjärta ikväll som säger, "Jag tränger att ta en bestämmelse här ikväll"?
He's calling you.
Han kallar på dig.
And you see, the call was urgent.
Detta kallar var väldigt nödvändigt och det var starkt.
Zacchaeus, come down here quickly. Come on.
Han sa, Zacchaeus, kom ned, nå raskt med en gång.
Is he calling you tonight?
Kallar han dig ikväll?
Now he had a choice.
Han hade ju då ett val.
Zacchaeus could just sit there in the tree.
Zacchaeus kunde blivit värne där I trädet.
He could maybe read the next day paper to see what the editorial page had to say.
Han kunde ha suttit och läst dagens aviser och sett vad skulle ske vidare.
Jesus called him and said, "Come quickly."
Men Jesus kallade honom och sa, "Kom med en gång."
He had a choice.
Och då hade han ett val.
He could sit there or obey.
Han kunde bli sittna eller lytta.
And Zacchaeus, when he heard that call, he came, he obeyed.
Och när Zacchaeus hörde kallet, så kom han och adlöd.
Tonight will you obey.
I kväll vill du adlyda.
I'm going to invite you in just a moment.
Jag ska invitera dig om bara ett litet ögonblick.
To get up out of your seat and stand here.
Att du ska komma upp från där du sitter och komma ned och bli stående här nere.
To confess your sin to God.
Där du ska bekänna dina synder till Gud.
To tell him you're sorry.
Fortell han att du ångrar på dina synder.
And by faith to believe on the name of Jesus Christ.
Och vi tror att du kan tro på Jesu namn.
Who took your sins?
Han som tog dina synder.
Who died in your place?
Som döde I ditt ställe.
Whom God raised alive?
Som Gud uppreiste till liv.
Jesus Christ is not dead.
Jesus Kristus är inte död.
He's not still hanging on a cross like some artists like to depict him.
Han hänger inte fortsatt på korset som konstnärerna av och till framställer honom.
His tomb is empty.
Hans grav är tom.
He's alive.
Han lever.
He's here tonight.
Han är här ikväll.
And he'll come into your life and to your heart if you'll trust him.
Han kommer till ditt liv och till ditt hjärta om du har tilltro till honom.
Zacchaeus obeyed.
Zacchaeus adlöd.
And he came to Jesus.
Han kom till Jesus.
And when he came to Jesus.
När han kom till Jesus.
He jumped right out of that tree.
Så spratt han rätt ut av trädet Zacchaeus.
The Bible says salvation is found in no one else, for there's no other name under heaven given to men by which we must be saved.
Frälse finns inte I någon där, inte någon annat namn under himlen vid vilket man kan bli frälst.
The Bible says whoever believes in the Son has eternal life.
Bibeln säger att den som tror på sonen har evig liv.
But whoever rejects the Son will not see life.
Men den som avvisar sonen vill aldrig se livet.
For God's wrath remains on him.
För Guds vrede förblir över honom.
The Bible says without faith it's impossible to please God.
Bibeln säger utan tro är det omöjligt att behaga Gud.
Because anyone who comes to him must believe that he exists.
För den som tror på honom och tror att han existerar.
And he rewards those who earnestly seek him.
Att han belönar dem som söker han uppriktigt.
Will you come to Christ tonight?
Vill du komma till Kristus ikväll?
Oh, you say, what's the reward?
Ja, men vad slags belöning snackar vi om här?
Your sins forgiven?
Dina synder är tillgitt.
That's a pretty good reward.
Det är en ganska bra belöning.
You can have a relationship with God tonight.
Du kan ha relation med Gud från ikväll av.
A personal relationship.
En personlig relation.
Through Jesus Christ.
Genom Jesus Kristus.
That's what you get. That's a pretty good reward.
Det är en ganska god belöning det också.
You get a new life, a new beginning.
Du får ett nytt liv, en ny begynnelse.
The Bible says, behold, all things become new.
Bibeln säger att allt är blivit nytt.
You have a new life.
Du får ett nytt liv.
Your soul is secure in the hands of God.
Din själ är nu säker I Guds händer.
He wants to reward you.
Han vill belöna dig.
He wants to forgive you.
Han vill tillge dig.
He wants to make you his son or daughter.
Han vill göra dig till sin son eller dotter.
And Zacchaeus jumps out of that tree and he receives Christ.
Och Zacchaeus kommer så fort ner av detta trädet och han tar emot Kristus.
And I want you to receive Christ tonight by faith.
Och jag vill att du ska ta emot Kristus ikväll med tro.
The Bible says, "By grace are we saved."
Bibeln säger att för nåde är vi frälst.
Through faith.
Ved tro.
Not of works.
Det icke ved gjerninger.
Lest you boast.
Så att icke du ska ha något att skryta av.
We're saved by God's grace through faith.
Vi är frälst ved hans nåde genom tro.
The Bible says to all who received him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God.
Bibeln säger att alla de som tog emot han fick rätt till att bli Guds barn.
You can become a child of God tonight.
Du kan bli ett Guds barn ikväll.
You see, Zacchaeus, when he hit the ground, he called Jesus his Lord.
Du ser så fort Zacchaeus träff backen så bekänt han att Jesus, du är Herre.
His Lord.
Du är Herre.
Will you make Jesus Christ the Lord of your life?
Vill du göra Jesus till Herre I ditt liv?
The Bible said, Jesus said, whoever acknowledges me before men, I will also acknowledge him before my Father in heaven.
Bibeln säger att den som bekänner mig för människor vill jag också bekänna för min far I himmelen.
Zacchaeus called him Lord.
Zacchaeus kallade honom Herre.
And the Bible says, if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you shall be saved.
Och Bibeln säger att om du bekänner med din mun att Jesus är Herre och tror I ditt hjärta att Gud har uppreist honom från de döda, så skall du bli frälst.
Are you saved?
Är du frälst?
Are you sure?
Är du säker?
You can be sure tonight.
Du kan vara helt säker ikväll.
I'm going to give you that opportunity. Just in a minute.
Jag ska ge dig den möjligheten om bara ett litet ögonblick.
But if you come to Christ, you've got to be willing to repent.
Om du kommer till Kristus så må du vara villig till att omvända dig.
It's going to cost you.
Detta här kostar dig alltså.
You have to turn from your sins.
Du må vända dig från dina synder.
Some of you are in a sexual relationship that's not right.
Någon av er är I ett sexuell relation som inte är helt riktig.
You're going to have to turn from that.
Du må vara villig till att vända dig bort från
dem. Some of you are involved in things that are dishonest.
Någon är involverad I ting som helt är uärliga.
You're going to have to turn from that.
Du må vende deg bort fra det.
You say, but Franklin, I'd like to.
Men Franklin sier du, men jeg skulle gjerne gjort det.
But you don't understand the power and the sex drive that I have, and I don't think I can just quit.
Men du skjønner jo ikke den kraften som denne seksuelle driften har I meg. Jeg kan ikke bare slutte.
You come to Christ tonight.
Når du kommer til Kristus I kveld.
God's Holy Spirit will come in you.
Så kommer Guds hellige ånd inn I deg.
And He will help you.
Og det han som kommer til å hjelpe deg med dette.
You say, but Franklin, it's hard for me just to quit drinking. I love drinking.
Ja, men det vanskelig for meg å bare slutte å drikke. Jeg elsker å drikke.
And I drink too much. I don't know how to stop.
Og jeg drikker alt for mye. Jeg vet ikke hvordan jeg skal få slutt på det.
You come to Christ. He gives you the strength.
Når du kommer til Kristus I kveld, så det han som gir deg styrken til det.
And you see, Zacchaeus, when he stood before Jesus.
Du ser Zacchaeus når han stod framfor Jesus.
He confessed his sin.
Så bekjente han sin synd.
He said, "I'm going to give half of my possessions to the poor."
Han sa, "Jeg gir halvparten av det jeg eier til de fattige."
You see, he's been cheating people for years.
Fordi at han hadde jo lurt mennesker for penger hele sitt liv.
He says, "Now I'm going to give half of my money to the poor."
Så han sa, "Men jeg gir halvparten av det jeg eier til de fattige."
And any person that I have cheated, I'm going to pay them back, not the money that I took, but fourfold.
Og har jeg lurt noen og de kommer med dette her sånn, så skal jeg gi dem tilbake ikke det jeg har tatt fra dem, men de får fire ganger igjen.
It was evident that this man was changed his life.
Det var helt åpenbart at denne mannen hadde totalt forandret sitt liv.
When he met Jesus.
Når han møtte Jesus.
Jesus was coming through Jericho.
Så var Jesus på vei gjennom Jericho.
Looks up and sees him.
Ser opp til han og ser ham I treet.
Stops.
Han stanser opp.
Calls him by name.
Kaller ham ved navn.
Come.
Kom, sier han.
And Zacchaeus came to Christ.
Og Zacchaeus kom til Kristus.
And that same Jesus 2,000 years ago.
Og det den samme Jesus som for 2,000 år siden.
Is calling you tonight.
Han kaller nå deg.
And he's saying, come.
Han sier nå, kom.
Come to me.
Kom til meg, sier han.
Put your trust in me.
Ha din tillit til meg.
Let me be the Lord of your life.
La meg få lov til å være herre I ditt liv.
Will you do that tonight?
Vil du gjøre det I kveld?
Jesus said, I have not come to call the righteous, but sinners to repentance.
Jesus sa, jeg har ikke kommet for å kalle de rettferdige, men syndere til omvendelse.
He came here for you.
Han kom hit for deg.
Jesus came here for you.
Jesus kom hit
He's
for din
calling sin. You.
Han kaller deg.
Will you come to him tonight?
Vil du komme til han I kveld?
If you're here tonight,
om du her I kveld,
and you're not sure that your sins are forgiven,
og du ikke helt sikker på at dine synder deg tilgitt,
if you've never invited Christ into your heart,
om du aldri har invitert Jesus Kristus inn I ditt hjerte,
if you've never trusted him,
om du aldri har tillit til ham,
I want you to get up right now and come.
Så vil jeg at du skal reise deg akkurat nå,
stand
og så kommer
right
du fram,
here.
Så blir du stående her.
This call is urgent.
Dette kallet haster.
You may never have this chance again.
Du får kanskje aldri dette kallet igjen.
So I want you to get up and come quickly.
Så reis deg opp nå, og så kommer du med en gang fram.
You're not coming to Franklin Graham.
Du kommer ikke til Franklin Graham.
You're coming tonight to Jesus.
Du kommer I kveld til Jesus Kristus.
Who loves you.
Som elsker deg.
Who wants to forgive you.
Ønsker å tilgi deg.
Who wants to set you free.
Ønsker å sette deg fri.
But you have to come in repentance.
Men du må komme I omvendelse.
And you have to come in faith.
Og du må komme I tro.
So you come. Come on.
Så vær så snill. Kom en gang.
When we've all come, we'll have a word of prayer.
Når vi alle kommet, så skal vi be sammen.
sins forgiven?
Dine synder tilgitt?
Are you sure?
Du sikker på det?
You say, well, I think so.
Ja, jeg tror det, jeg tenker det.
I've been going to church most of my life.
Jeg faktisk har gått til kirke mesteparten av mitt liv.
That doesn't have anything to do with it.
Det har overhodet ikke med saken å gjøre.
And there are many people in the church.
Det mange mennesker I kirken.
That need to rededicate and recommit their lives to Christ.
Som trenger å gi sitt liv på nytt til Jesus Kristus.
And you need to come tonight.
Og du trenger å komme I kveld.
It's either heaven or hell.
Det enten himmel eller helvete.
You see, the Bible says God is patient with you.
Bibelen sier at Gud tålmodig med deg.
He's not wanting anyone to perish, but everyone to come in repentance.
Han vil ikke at noen skal gå fortapt, men at de skal komme til omvendelse.
And Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father but by me."
Og Jesus sier at jeg veien, sannheten og livet. Det ingen som kommer til Faderen uten ved meg.
Oh, there's not many ways to heaven.
Det ikke mange veier til himmelen.
There's only one way.
Det bare en vei.
And that's through the cross.
Og det gjennom korset.
Jesus shed his blood for you.
Jesus utgjød sitt blod for deg.
Will you come to him tonight?
Vil du komme til ham I kveld?
He's here.
Han her.
He'll forgive you.
Han vil tilgi deg.
He'll set you free.
Han vil sette deg fri.
Come.
Kom nå.
Come quickly.
Kom en gang.
Come.
Kom nå.
We're going to wait just a few more moments and give you an opportunity to come.
Vi venter litt grann til så du får anledning til å komme deg ned. Kanskje dere som sitter langt bak kan komme dere ned.
Just as you are, hear the Spirit call. Come just as you are. Come and see.
Come and see.
Come receive.
Come receive.
Still coming. We're going to wait.
Det fortsatt mennesker som på vei ned, så vi venter bittelitt grann til.
We want everyone to come.
Vi vil gjerne at du skal få mulighet å komme ned.
I want the band just to play quietly.
Musikken spiller bare stille rolig ved siden av her så.
Anyone else?
Det enda flere igjen?
Come.
Så vær så snill og kom nå.
Is he calling you tonight?
Kaller han på deg I kveld?
You say, well, Franklin, I may come tomorrow.
Så sier du, Franklin, jeg kan jo bestemme meg I morgen.
We won't be here tomorrow.
Vi ikke her I morgen.
You may not have this chance.
Og det ikke sikkert du får denne muligheten igjen.
You do it right now. Come on.
Bestem deg nå med en gang.
You come. If he's calling you, come.
Hvis han kaller på deg, så kom.
You say, but Franklin, it's kind of embarrassing to come in front of all these people.
Ja, Franklin, det veldig, veldig flaut for meg å komme foran alle disse menneskene da.
This crowd.
denne mengden av mennesker.
Well, Zacchaeus had that crowd problem.
Zacchaeus hadde det samme problemet med denne menneskemengden.
But he didn't let it stop him.
Han lot ikke stoppe han.
He came to Jesus.
Han kom til Jesus.
Come.
Kom nå.
Come.
Kom nå.
We're going to wait just another minute. Anyone else?
Så vi venter bittelitt grann til, sånn at de siste kan få lov til å komme og bestemme seg og bli med.
Anyone else?
Det noen enda flere?
Come.
Så kom nå.
Thank you.
I want to say a word to those of you that have come.
La meg få si noen få ord til dere som har kommet frem her.
By coming, you're saying to God, I'm a sinner.
Når du har kommet her, så sier du til Gud, jeg en synder.
You say, but Franklin, doesn't he know that?
Ja, sier du kanskje, men visste han ikke det fra før?
He knows that.
Jo da, han vet om det.
But he wants to hear you say it.
Men han vil gjerne at du skal si det.
And by coming tonight, you're saying to God, I'm sorry.
Og ved at du har kommet frem her, så sier du til Gud, Herre, jeg angrer.
And by coming to God, you're saying tonight, I'm willing to turn and leave my sin.
Og du sier også at jeg nå kommet til Gud, og jeg villig til å omvende meg og forlate min synd.
And by coming tonight, you're saying to God, I believe Jesus is your son.
Og ved å komme hit, så sier du også, jeg tror at Jesus Guds sønn.
That he took my sins.
At han tok min synd.
That he died in my place.
At han døde på mitt sted.
And that you raised him to life.
Og at han oppreiste ham til liv.
And I want to invite him to come into my heart.
Og at jeg vil invitere ham til å komme inn I mitt hjerte.
Now I want to lead you in a prayer.
Nå skal jeg få lede deg I en enkel bønn.
Now a prayer is just talking to God.
En bønn ganske enkelt å snakke med Gud.
Like I'm talking to you.
Akkurat som jeg snakker med deg.
So I want you just to repeat this out loud after me.
Så jeg vil at du skal gjenta det jeg ber høyt.
I'll do this in English.
Så begynner jeg han på engelsk.
And he will do this in Norwegian.
Og så tar jeg det på norsk og så gjentar dere etter meg da.
So you can just repeat this prayer after me. Now we're talking to God.
Du skal gjenta denne bønnen etter oss og så det du som snakker med Gud.
And if you pray this prayer in faith.
Og hvis du ber denne bønnen I tro.
God will hear your prayer.
Så hører Gud på din bønn.
And he'll forgive you.
Og han tilgir deg.
Let's pray.
La oss be.
Dear God.
Kjære Gud.
I am a sinner.
Jeg en synder. Jeg en synder.
I am sorry for my sins.
Jeg angrer på min synd. Jeg angrer på min synd.
Forgive me.
Tilgi meg. Tilgi meg.
I believe Jesus Christ is your son.
Jeg tror at Jesus Kristus din sønn. Jeg tror at Jesus Kristus din sønn.
I believe that he died on the cross for my sins.
Jeg tror han døde på korset for min synd. Jeg tror han døde på korset for min synd.
And that you raised him to life.
Og at du oppreiste ham til liv. At du oppreiste ham til liv.
I believe in Jesus.
Jeg tror på Jesus. Jeg tror på Jesus.
I want to trust Jesus as my savior.
Jeg vil ha tillit til Jesus som min frelser. Jeg vil ha tillit til Jesus som min frelser.
I want to trust Jesus as my Lord.
Jeg vil ha tillit til Jesus som min Herre. Jeg vil ha tillit til Jesus som min Herre.
And I pray this in Jesus' name.
Dette ber jeg I Jesu navn. Dette ber jeg I Jesu navn.
Amen.
Amen.